We'll stand for our introductory prayers. You are all beautiful, Mary, and the original stain is not in you. You are the glory of Jerusalem. You are the joy of Israel. You give honor to our people. You are the advocate of sinners. O Mary, Virgin most prudent, Mother most merciful, pray for us, intercede for us with the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay. O God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant, we pray, that as you preserve her from every stain by virtue of the death of your Son, which you foresaw, so through her intercession, we too may be cleansed and admitted to your presence. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Novena prayer, please all kneel. O most pure Virgin Mary, conceived without sin, from the very first instant, you were entirely immaculate. O glorious Mary, full of grace, you are the Mother of God, the Queen of angels and of men. I humbly venerate you as the chosen Mother of my Savior, Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace and the Lord of Lords. Chose you for the singular grace and honor of being his beloved mother. By the power of his cross, he preserved you from all sin. Therefore, by his power and love, I have hope and hold confidence in your prayers for my holiness and salvation. I pray that your prayers will bring me to imitate your holiness and submission to Jesus and the divine will. Queen of heaven, I beg you to beg my Savior to grant me this request. Mention your intentions. My Holy Mother, I know that you were obedient to the will of God in making this petition. I know that God's will is more perfect than mine. So grant that I may receive God's grace with humility as you did. As my final request, I ask that you pray for me to increase in faith in our risen Lord. I ask that you pray for me to increase in hope in our risen Lord. I ask that you pray for me to increase in love for the risen Jesus. Amen. Day 6, he has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. Prayer for the day. O Mother of sweet love and holy hope, before your feet I cast myself. Have compassion as sinners and enlighten our minds so that we may return to the Christian ways, and so that all the honors joys and sorrows that surround your life may bear fruit in us. My mother, may I always remain in your love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
Mother of Christ,
pray for us.
Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
Mother of Mercy,
pray for us.
Mother of Divine Grace,
pray for us.
Mother of Hope,
pray for us.
Mother Most Pure,
pray for us.
Mother Most Chaste,
pray for us.
Mother Inviolate,
pray for us.
Mother Undefiled,
pray for us.
Mother Most Amiable,
pray for us.
Mother Most Admirable,
pray for us.
Mother of Good Counsel,
pray for us.
Mother of our Creator,
pray for us.
Mother of our Savior,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Prudent,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Venerable,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Renowned,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Powerful,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Merciful,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Faithful,
pray for us.
Mirror of Justice,
pray for us.
Seat of Wisdom,
pray for us.
Cause of our Joy,
pray for us.
Spiritual Vessel,
pray for us.
Vessel of Honor,
pray for us.
Singular Vessel of Devotion,
pray for us.
Mystical Rose,
pray for us.
Tower of David,
pray for us.
Tower of Ivory,
pray for us.
House of Gold,
pray for us.
Ark of the Covenant,
pray for us.
Gate of Heaven,
pray for us.
Morning Star,
pray for us.
Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Refuge of Sinners,
pray for us.
Solace of Migrants,
pray for us.
Comforter of the Afflicted,
pray for us.
Help of Christians,
pray for us.
Queen of Angels,
pray for us.
Queen of Patriarchs,
pray for us.
Queen of Prophets,
pray for us.
Queen of Apostles,
pray for us.
Queen of Martyrs,
pray for us.
Queen of Confessors,
pray for us.
Queen of Virgins,
pray for us.
Queen of All Saints,
pray for us.
Queen conceived without original sin,
pray for us.
Queen assumed into heaven,
pray for us.
Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
Queen of Families,
pray for us.
Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Memorare. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you do I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy, hear and answer me. Amen. Pope Francis' prayer to Mary Immaculate. Virgin most holy and immaculate, to you the honor of our people and our loving protector, do we turn with loving trust. You are all beautiful, O Mary. In you there is no sin. Awaken in all of us a renewed desire for holiness. May the splendor of truth shine forth in our words, the song of charity resound in our works, purity and chastity abide in our hearts and bodies, and the full beauty of the gospel be evident in our lives. You are all beautiful, O Mary. In you the Word of God became flesh. Help us always to heed the Lord's voice. May we never be indifferent to the cry of the poor or untouched by the sufferings of the sick and those in need. May we be sensitive to the loneliness of the elderly and the vulnerability of children, and always love and cherish the life of every human being. You are all beautiful, O Mary. In you is the fullness of joy, born of life with God. Help us never to forget the meaning of our earthly journey. May the kindly light of faith illumine our days, the comforting power of hope direct our steps, the contagious warmth of love steer our hearts, and may our gaze be fixed on God, in whom true joy is found. You are all beautiful, O Mary. Hear our prayer, graciously hear our plea. May the beauty of God's merciful love in Jesus abide in our hearts, and may this divine beauty save us, our city, and the entire world. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault.
Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who will that at the message of the angel, your word should take flesh in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, grant that we who pray to you and believe her to be truly the Mother of God may be helped by her interceding before you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On that day, they will sing this song in the land of Judah. A strong city have we. He sets up walls and ramparts to protect us. Open up the gates to let in a nation that is just, one that keeps faith, a nation of firm purpose you keep in peace. In peace, for its trust in you. Trust in the Lord forever. For the Lord is an eternal rock. He humbles those in high places, and the lofty city he brings down. He tumbles it to the ground, levels it with the dust. It is trampled underfoot by the needy, by the footsteps of the poor. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Open to me the gates of justice. I will enter them and give thanks to the Lord. This gate is the Lord's. The just shall enter it. I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me and have been my Savior.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
O Lord, grant salvation. O Lord, grant prosperity. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us life.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Please stand to honor the Holy Gospel.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my heavenly Father. Everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, but it did not collapse. It had been set solidly on rock. And everyone who listens to these words of mine but does not act on them will be like a fool who built his house on sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, and it collapsed and was completely ruined." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good noon to all of you. Magandang tanghali sa inyong lahat. What honor to celebrate the Holy Eucharist in Manila Cathedral. First of all, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Monsignor Rolly de la Cruz and Father Will and the Manila Cathedral community to invite me to celebrate one of the novena masses in honor of Our Lady, the Immaculate Conception. My dear friends, two houses and two cities. The gospel reading today poses this question: who will enter the kingdom of God? Jesus told us, not everyone who says, "Lord, Lord," will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven. To illustrate the vital importance of acting on the Word of God, two images are used in the readings today: two houses and two cities. The difference of the two houses in the Gospel is the foundation, one on rock, the other one on sand. The difference of two cities in the first reading, one on the Word of God, protected by the power of God, the other on human wisdom. What voices are we listening to? Are we building our Christian life on the firm foundation of the Word of God? And this is the answer lies in you and me. My dear friends, as we celebrate the
6-day novena in honor of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The Church invites us to magnify God and to give glory to Mary. The Immaculate Conception is God's divine intervention in preparation for her son Jesus, born of woman, born under the law. At this moment, we already have 5 novena masses. I assume that you all know the dogma of the Immaculate Conception. Just to sum up this dogma, note the following facts. First, Mary's Immaculate Conception in her mother's womb is God's divine action. Second, Mary was never being stained by original sin. Third, her Immaculate Conception is a part of Jesus' redemptive action effected in her in advance. And number 4, Mary lives the rest of her life without sin. Therefore, let us glorify God and honor Mary. As in my priestly life, I see Mary as Mary, model and mother of priests. Mary is being the model of the doers of the word and the holiness of life for all us priests. Well, it's for all Christians and especially for us priests. As I recalled my 25 years of the experience of ministering God's word and the sacraments, I can only honestly admit that I am still a priest because of God's mercy and forgiveness and the inspiration of the Blessed Virgin Mary. In responding to the call to the priesthood, both in formation and as a priest, I found out Mary has always been part of my life, inspiring me to seek Jesus and doing the will of the Father. It is through the Holy Rosary Mary has guided and inspired me. I was born in a devout Catholic family from China, and my parents had 5 sons. 2 of us became priests. In fact, my eldest brother now is the bishop in my hometown, Hebei, China, and me as a missionary priest of the Lorenzo Ruiz Mission Society here in the Philippines. And Cardinal Sin has been our founder. I was told by my mom just 10 years ago, then I was 15 years as a priest. So when 2 of us, my elder brother and I, were seminarians, my parents would offer daily 1 rosary for me, 1 rosary for my brother Peter. When 2 of us became priests, my parents doubled their prayers. They would offer 2 rosaries for me, 2 rosaries for my brother. And my mom told me just 15 years ago, she said, "I know it is more difficult to be and remain a good priest. That's why your Father and I doubled our prayers. We ask Mother Mary to protect and to guide you. My brothers and sisters, I know not only my parents are praying for me, all the Catholic faithful, even here in Manila Cathedral, you have been praying for us priests. You are my father, you are my mothers for me. I am ever grateful for your prayers, especially through the intercession of Mama Mary, that she has been guiding and helping me. The next experience, I see Mary as woman of faith. Last June, I was told by my superior, I will be assigned in Immaculate Conception Parish, Damar, Quezon City. I was really troubled because, having been in the Philippines for 32 years, 25 years as a priest, Quezon City is one of the unknown city for me. If Manila, Makati, Mandaluyong, Pasig, Pasay, okay na. But for me to about Quezon City, I was afraid. And I had my 5-day Ignatian retreat in Novaliches under the Jesuit. And it is my prayer with the joyful mysteries which the Jesuit priest suggested me. And I was guided to meditate on the mysteries of Mary, all the joyful mysteries. And it is through that retreat I understand better the struggle of Mary, how Mary put her faith in the Word of God, and she was giving her all to Jesus, to the Word of God. And even though when the angel Gabriel told her, you will be the mother of God, you will conceive and bear a son, Saint Luke in the Annunciation record that Mary just had two questions. In fact, the angel Gabriel was always the one who did the talking. Mary listened attentively and with eager and with faith. And Mary just said, how did this happen since I don't know men? The second answer is, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done to me according to your word. Mary has been attentive listener to the word of God, and she was the woman of faith, trusting in God, trusting everything. That's why even in the visitation, in the birth of Jesus, in the account of the presentation Jesus in the temple, the conversation between Simeon and Anna, Mary kept all these things in her heart, meditating on them. And she was the woman of faith. Because of the inspiration of Mother Mary, because her faith, I was enlightened. I find the Lord is telling me, Father Joseph, do not be afraid to be a parish priest in Damar. Don't be afraid to go to the city called Quezon City, because in that place, there two group of people, the Filipino Chinese, and we call the urban poor, we call it 2 to 4. And I am not good in Tagalog. That's why takot ako. I am really afraid and trembling. But through the retreat, I find inspiration through Mother Mary. Mother Mary is more afraid. Mother Mary has all reason to fear. But through her inspiration, I told my superior and later to Bishop Ernesto Antioco, yes, I will go, because I said yes to my superior, of course, to Cardinal Advencula and to Bishop Ernesto Antioco, the Bishop of Cubao. I said yes because of the inspiration of Mother Mary. So, my dear brothers and sisters, as we continue the 6-day novena in honor of Mary, the Immaculate Conception, let us be imitators of Mary. Be the attentive listener to the Word of God. Be a man and woman of faith. Be a man of woman of the doers of the Word. Mary, Immaculate Conception, pray for us. Please all stand. Confident that He will grant us what we ask for, we make our prayers to God the Father in a sincere heart. Let the response be, Loving Father, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That the Pope, bishops, priests, and religious may be faithful to their commitment to God, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That politicians and all those who serve in government may be faithful to their promises and obligations, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That our faith may find solid ground in our examples rather than in our words, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That all of us who handle duties and responsibilities may carry out our tasks efficiently, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That our departed relatives and friends may finally receive their heavenly reward, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
Father, you are our strength in time of need. Open our hearts to your grace and lead us into your kingdom. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God through mighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, these offerings, and by your power change them into the sacrament of salvation, in which, fulfilling the sacrifices of the fathers, is offered the true Lamb, Jesus Christ, your Son, born of the ever-Virgin Mary, in a way beyond all human telling, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of the human flesh, so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so, with the angels and archangels, with the thrones and the dominions, and with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you,
and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Oh.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold Jesus, the Son of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Lamb of God who take away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and the blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Mula sa atin.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May the mysteries we have received, O Lord our God, always show forth your mercy in us, that we, who commemorate in faith the mother of your Son, may be saved by his incarnation, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Good afternoon. Please be seated. Before Father Joseph gives the final blessing, let me take this opportunity to thank him for saying yes, like Mary, to the invitation of the Lord. No? And I know that it was a kind of intimidating to say the Eucharist, to celebrate the Eucharist here at the Manila Cathedral. And more, I am discovering that not many priests have celebrated as presider in this cathedral in their lives. So, Father Joseph, thank you for saying yes to our invitation. And the life of Father Joseph proves, no, that the support and prayer of parents are very important. Vocations to the priesthood, in order to flourish, must be nourished by the prayers and support of the family and the parents. Imagine, no, one of them is a bishop, his brother, and he is a priest. And the parents doubled their prayer, no, in order to support their sons in the priestly ministry. Kaya po, if you want your children, your sons, to be priests, offer rosary for them. And if you have priests, or you know priests, a friend who have been part of your life also as a family friend, please pray for them. Pray for us. So, Father Joseph, thank you, and as a sign of our appreciation, we are giving you the replica of the image of the Immaculate Conception enshrined here at the Manila Cathedral. Thank you. Okay, so thank you. And again, I would like to thank you for joining us in this Eucharistic celebration as we prepare for the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception this coming Monday, December 9. On Sunday, December 8, though it will be second Sunday of Advent, in the evening after the 6 p.m. Mass that will be presided over by the Apostolic Nuncio, Archbishop Charles Brown, we will have the procession of the three images of the Miraculous Medal, the Immaculate Conception that is at your left, and Our Lady of Lourdes. This is in part, no, this is part of the commemoration of the 170th anniversary of the dogma of the Immaculate Conception. So join us in this Mass on Sunday, and please join the procession also. No, hindi naman malayo ang ating lalakarin. Mula lang dito hanggang siguro Cubao, no? Okay? Malapit-lapit lang 'yon. No, hindi, joke lang. So we'll just be going around Intramuros. So bring candles if you plan to join the procession. Thank you.
Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary, willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessing. Amen.
Amen.
May you know always and everywhere the protection of her, through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life.
Amen.
May you, who have devoutly gathered on this day, carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.